Hey everyone, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. So I'm here with another dye feature series video. I'm trying to get back into the habit of crafting more frequently, so I figured let's do a feature video. I just, you know, opened one of the boxes and I started looking through dyes. Okay, so I decided to do a dye feature on the Card Making Magic 6x6 Heart Box. This was the dye that I was attempting to destash recently, because I bought it and I never used it. So I figured, let me destash it. I don't think I'm going to be using the heart box all that frequently, but it didn't sell, so I decided to go ahead and play with it. It is a very cute die, so let me go ahead and bring in the die. I still have it in its original packaging. Because I was trying to destash it, I didn't take it out. And I don't know if I'm still going to keep it. It is a very cute die, but again, I'm not a big hearts person, so how often I will actually use this die is the only reason why I was thinking about destashing. I only played with the 6x6. I do have the 4x4, which is essentially the same thing, just a little bit smaller, and the decorative center is different. But yeah, from the looks of it, everything looks to be the same. They both have the flowers, a different border, the ribbon, and two different bows. This one has a dimensional bow. This one looks like it's just a flat bow. But we're not talking about this one. If you do enjoy the die itself, this one, Card Making Magic, is exclusive to Craft Stash. On the Craft Stash US site, the 4x4 is, what is it? I believe it shows it's $21.50 and the 6x6 box is $31.50. So that is the retail US price for the 6x6 box. It comes with 23 dies in the die set. As you can see, you have, this is the main lid. This decorative flowery insert is separate, so you don't have to cut it into your lid if you don't want to. You have a scalloped edge. You have an edge with a stitched lining on the inside. You have a heart, which is more of a matting layer for this one, where you get the stitched on line on the inside and on the outside. You have two other solid hearts that you can use. And I'm assuming one is slightly, I think this one is slightly smaller, so you can create a card to go inside the box. Oops, and I'm out of frame. Christina Griffith creates her boxes and she always typically gives you a matting piece so you can cut a card to fit inside of all of our boxes. Here you have the panel pieces. The skinnier one here is the one that is used on the lid, and this is the one for the base of the box. Here you have this ribbonish border, and you also have the smaller border over here. This one does not have a cutting edge at the very end of each one, so you can continue to make your border even longer as long as you line it up. This one here does have the edge. It does cut it off at the edge. For my project, I used, of course, the base. I did use this insert. I used the border, of course, the sides for the lid. I did not use any of the flowers and greenery that came with this die. The box itself wasn't difficult to put together. The only, one of the cons that I say is here where you see, I'm gonna show this up here, where you have the, what we call the teeth of the panels, there's no score line there, so you could evenly crease all of the teeth. I wouldn't say a lot of dies, but typically when you have something with teeth like that, it does have a guide. Typically, I use SVG files when I have files that have these type of teeth, and it does give you a perforated edge so you have a clean line of where you're folding. If you're trying to manually fold the teeth, they're not going to be 100% lined up. It still works because that's the way I assembled the box, but it's not 100% aligned, so I did do a little something to try to cover up where it wasn't even on the seams. But easy solution to that, if you have a scoreboard, you can line this up and draw your own score line along the edge, the back end of the teeth. That way you have an even line when you're creasing the teeth to shape it around the heart to create your shape for the box. That is the only thing that I think is kind of a little drawback. It would have been nice if it had some kind of guideline for the crease, but I can totally see why it was not created. It is right at the edge of the die, so it could be problematic. Who knows? But that is it. That is the one thing that I really saw as a drawback. Everything else works great. As you can see, here are all the different pieces. It is a nice sized box. The dies themselves, they're not crazy, crazy flimsy, but they're also not super strong, but they do work. I think like the larger frames, of course, very, very minimal amount of metal, so they do bend, but they still get the job done. And let's put those back inside. Typically, I do a lot of pros and cons when it comes to these Die Features series videos, but the box is relatively straightforward. Christina does have tutorials, and she does do inspiration and examples on all of her dies that she creates, so you can just check out her YouTube channel, and you can get inspiration. She does tutorials, she assembles boxes together, all that nature. She has tons of different boxes, so you can definitely check out her channel for that. I did not do an assembly video to show you how to assemble it. It is time consuming for the video that I'm trying to post. I'm trying to keep this under 15 minutes, so a tutorial wouldn't work for that. And again, there are tutorials on YouTube from Christina to help you assemble this. But yeah, that is essentially it. Again, this is $31.50 US retail from Craft Stash. You do have different CN exchange rates because this does come from the UK. Even though you're buying on the Craft Stash US website, they don't have a United States warehouse. It's still coming from the UK. So you are going to have to wait several weeks to get this if you do order it. I think Paper Wishes here in the US carries some card making magic, and sometimes they have specials, but they don't carry her entire line. So I don't know if they have it there. I have not looked. So if you want, you can check out Paper Wishes and see if you can get it through them. Otherwise, you're only going to be getting this on Craft Stash. Okay, that is about it when it comes to the die. Just a little recap. Again, it is a 6x6 medium heart box, and there are 23 dies in this die set. Okay, so now to the project. We're going to be super quick about it. Here is the completed box. Again, it is a 6x6 box in the shape of a heart. It is quite dimensional. It is about, I don't have a ruler in front of me, but I'm kind of guesstimating that it's about 3 to 3.25 inches in height. But it is super, super cute. Again, when I was creasing the teeth, I did do it manually. I didn't use a scoreboard, so some of mine were uneven. So I took this bling trim to cover up where it didn't line up properly because you could see it. So that was my solution to fix it, because again, I'm not a perfect crafter either. If I make mistakes, I do find ways to cover them up. I won't necessarily start all over again unless it is seriously a detrimental error, then I'll start all over again. But just it being unaligned and it not being even, simple solution, use bling trim. I was searching for this last night and I couldn't find it, so I was irritated because I wanted to finish this project last night and I couldn't do it. So I walked away, I left the box, I came back into my craft room this morning and I started looking around because I had seen the bling trim like 2 days before, so I was irritated that I couldn't find it again. But I did find it, so I was able to finish the project so I can record this video. So again, I think this is SS10. This is a bling rhinestone trim. I bought this off of Amazon. I think I bought like 10 yards. Here we have, these are my blossom number twos. These are the flowers that I create that I label blossom number two. These are the 1 3/4 inch size that I have here. I have three of them in black lined up. Then these leaves come from the Heartfelt Creations. This is the floral urn, that the urn die that they have. This is the leaf set that comes with it. I cut it out 3 different times. I tucked two, one on each end, and then I cut one apart and I stuck it in on the sides. This gold foil like berries, that is a Sue Wilson die, and I put it away. It's called the Berry Bough. That's what that die is. It's the Berry Bough. The cardstock itself is 110-pound Recollections. The gold is a 90-pound bright gold foil that I used to buy from Paper and More. I don't know the brand of it, but Paper and More did close their store, so they're having a going out of business sale, so all of the good stuff is gone. But that is what it was. Let's see. This green is Pop Tone and Jelly Bean Green, and that is essentially it. For the side of the box, I didn't really do that much. I did use the border, that ribbon border, and I lined it all the way around the top of the box. I was gonna cut it out and put it at the bottom as well, but I got lazy. But if I do plan on giving this away, I think I am gonna end up cutting this again and then placing it down here at the bottom so I could have it all the way around. There is the bottom. It is a little bit messy. I wasn't really that neat about it. If we open it, I did put some shred inside so I can stick some treats, chocolates, or whatever instead of just having it flat on the bottom of the box. But the shred is already in there in case, like, let's see, if I want to put, you know, give away some poinsettias to somebody, who knows, or just treats, I can go ahead and put them inside. Now, I will tell you, I'm not a shred fan. I hate shred. I hate sequins. I hate all the confetti that people put in their packages. That's not my jam. So I'm actually reusing this from something that someone else sent me. But yeah, typically when I get it, it drives me crazy. And I know it looks beautiful and people love putting so much effort into their packaging, and it's definitely appreciated. But that's one of those things that I can't stand. I absolutely, absolutely hate it. When I get a package like that, I'll pull everything out and I dump it out. Because it drives me nuts. It gets everywhere. It's messy. Even though it is beautiful and it makes everything look wonderful, I can't stand it. So you rarely ever see me use it. I'll use paper shred like this because this is a lot easier to clean up. But like the confetti, the sequins, that type of stuff, oh my God, that drives me up the wall. You will never see me put that in anybody's package. But again, it is super beautiful. Again, I digress. I'm like ranting off topic, not even having anything to do with this box. But it is what it is. I ramble in my videos. You guys all know this. But yeah, here is my completed project. It is a super cute box. It did not take a very long time to put together. It was, I think between the die cutting and actually gluing everything together, this putting it together, I don't think took more than 10 minutes. And that was, you know, and I think that's it. That is including the die cutting. I wasn't really timing it, but it couldn't have been more than 10 minutes. It was super, super quick to put together. Sometimes dealing with the teeth and lining things up can get a little frustrating for some people, but the more you practice, the quicker it goes. I do a lot of projects with those teeth. If you're familiar, the Dreaming Tree SVG files, a lot of their dimensional projects have those type of teeth. So whenever I do something of theirs, I'm used to it. So it moves a lot quicker for me. The first time that you do this, if you are not used to dealing with those type of teeth on for dimensional projects, it probably will take you a little bit longer than 10 minutes. So don't quote me on it. Just because I did it quickly doesn't mean that it's gonna be that quick for everybody. The more you practice, the more you get comfortable, the easier it is, it's going to be for you. Now, do I think this is worth $31? With this day and age, with all the different anti-ally dyes, a lot of people aren't going to pay $31.54 a dye, especially when you have to pay with the shipping overseas. Usually it's about $10, I think, if you spend over $50. I don't think Craft Stash does free shipping unless... Is it 75 or 100? I can't remember. I haven't really shopped in a really long time, so I'm kind of out of the game when it comes to some of the shipping rates. But would I pay $31 again? Probably not. If you're going to invest that kind of money, I would suggest you going with tonic dyes. Card making magic? Maybe. I won't say that it's not worth it. To each their own. Everybody has their own opinion. I probably wouldn't do it again. And I don't think I paid $31. I believe I had a coupon code and I also had the Craft Stash rewards. So I did a large purchase. They had a really big sale when I purchased this, and I spent quite a bit of money. I bought a whole bunch of stuff, so I got a savings. So I would say, on average, if I deduct the discount percentage off of the dye, I probably paid I want to say I probably didn't pay more than $25 for this dye. I don't have my receipt because I bought this a while ago. But I probably paid $25 less. I had free shipping, so it outweighed the benefits of saving with the sale did outweigh the cost of the dye itself. If it was just the dye by itself and then paying shipping, I wouldn't pay for it. I would combine it again, wait for a sale. But that's kind of it. I rambled a lot. But again, here is the box. Super duper cute. The 4x4 will probably be just as cute, just smaller. Will I make it? Probably. I'll probably make it for Valentine's Day, maybe for, boxes for treats for my mom, my kids, whatever. So yeah, I'll probably play with this later and I'll do a video. But again, if you're interested, you can buy these on Craft Stash. And that is about it. It is a super cute die. So you guys can make up your own mind and see if it's something that you want, if you don't already have it, and get to purchasing if you do already. If you have any questions, comment below, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!